Please subscribe to the English web and do not forget to click the bell icon to stay notified at all times. Hello everyone, welcome back to the English web. I am Bageshree Mehta. In today's video, I shall be giving you all some tips on how to improve your writing for IELTS. I took my IELTS some time ago and I have a lot of experiences to share. I am also going to talk about the mistakes that I made, which ended up fetching me a score of 7 bands on writing, which is clearly not a very good score. So let me start with tip number one. Tip number one is sticking to the word limit. You will have two tasks under your writing section. Task one is either a report or a letter. It is if you are taking an academic test, then you will have to write a report, and if you are taking the general IELTS, then you have to write a letter. In either case, you have to ensure that you meet the four parameters that you will be assessed upon. The first parameter is your task achievement or task response. The second parameter is your grammatical range. The third parameter is the development of your ideas, how well you structure them. And the fourth bit is the vocabulary that you use. So coming back to the first point, stick to the word limit. If you've been asked to write a 250 word essay, which is the second part of your writing assignment, do not go overboard writing, say, 350 words or 400 words. That's a mistake I made. It's a sign of desperation. When I started writing, I had so many ideas in my mind that I couldn't help but just fill pages. And the word limit came to 400 words, which is clearly not very good, which made me lose a lot of marks. So ensure that you stick to the word limit and not go overboard. Tip number two is writing to the point. Do not put a lot of emphasis on the ideas that you come up with, because unfortunately IELTS doesn't assess you on the type of ideas that you've come up with. Your main aim is to ensure that you've given the response to the question that you've been asked. So don't try to come up with a lot of fancy ideas or interesting thoughts. That is clearly not the point. You will just waste your time developing them. Ensure that you understand what the question is asking you to write, and then just write to the point. Which brings me to my third point, which is write in a very formal tone. When I talk about not putting a lot of time in writing, very like expressing a lot of fancy ideas, I also mean that you have to stick to that formal tone. You stick to the point and also use a formal tone. Don't use words like eventually, actually. No, that's a very friendly tone, and that is not the purpose of your IELTS writing test. They don't want to know how well you can speak. It's your writing test. Stick to formality and write your test. The fourth point, which is again a very, very important point, try and experiment with the sentences that you are using in your writing. Don't stick to just simple or compound sentences. Use simple, compound, complex sentences. I shall do another video on the types of sentences that you must include. But for now, I would like to talk about which are the types of sentences you can use. You should also use conditional sentences, sentences that start with if. Use a sentence which is in the passive voice. So try and experiment with these things. This will show the examiner that you know you have fluency, and there is a wide range of sentences that you have a hold of. Yes, ensure that you have your basics correct and try and experiment with these types of sentences. They will really have a very big impact on the examiner. So that is the fourth point. And the last point in today's video that I will talk about is ensuring that you do not sound repetitive. Yes, ensure that you have a proper structure in place. So there are four paragraphs that you must divide your report and essay in. And then ensure that you develop your ideas in a very structured format without repeating any words or sentences or repeating your thoughts. That does not leave a good impression. It only means that you are lacking the potential to come up with words or, you know, anything to write about, which is why it's important that you do that. It's a very mandatory thing. Ensure that you stick to the point, you don't repeat yourself, and don't make the essay or the report very monotonous. Ensure your ideas are crisp, clear and then end the essay or the report. That is the main aim of IELTS. So these are the five tips. I shall take you all through all these five tips again. Tip number one is sticking to the word limit, not writing more than what is required or not even writing less than what is required. Tip number two is sticking to the point and not putting a lot of time in coming up with elaborate ideas. That is not what is required. Tip number three is using a formal tone. Very important, again, very essential that you have your mind in place and just give the points that are actually required for the essay. Tip number four, using different types of sentences. Try and ensure that you have used a varied or diverse range of sentences in your essay and report. And tip number five is not sounding repetitive. Be clear, crisp, and show that there is clarity in your thoughts. So that was about it. I hope you guys liked my video. If you all did, please do not forget to give a big thumbs up to my video and subscribe to the English Web. I shall see you guys in my next video. Bye.